that the view was in 2020, they need to get Trump out at all costs, and Joe Biden was the best choice. You know, the liberal media leaned in and helped them. But there's no motivation to bring this guy back. It's actually quite sad.
But isn't that, Richard, the case on both sides? I get the feeling that if either side swapped their candidate at this point, they'd have a very good chance of winning, because these men are both deeply unpopular in certain sections of the electorate.
Well, that's certainly what the poll numbers are saying. If the Republican Party would return to the Republican Party of George W. Bush and John McCain and Mitt Romney, I think they'd have a slam dunk election victory in 2024. The Democratic Party has a number of people they ought to be considering as well. But one of my criticisms of the Biden administration is they were so slow to appoint independent counsel on this the federal case. The independent counsel should have been appointed in January of 2021, and I repeatedly urged that in both private conversations with advisors for President Biden and publicly in op-eds and other venues. And if Jack Smith had been appointed in January of 2021 and had been able to get his investigation going, these cases could very well have been brought a lot sooner, and we wouldn't now be on the verge of an election where the Republican Party has the right to choose a candidate without uncertainty about whether that candidate will be a convicted felon by the time they're running that candidate in the November election. So this has been a very, very slow process. In the investigation, the prosecution, it's all now finally coming to a head, but the Biden administration should have been going on that a lot sooner.
Okay.
As many of us urged in January 2021. And they also should have appointed.
Yeah, I was just going to say, you can see that there are Trump supporters in Georgia tonight. So many of them, particularly within the Republican base, are convinced that, still convinced, a large portion of them still convinced that he won the 2020 election. We're going to talk about that in the second hour of the program and the debate last night. We'll weave in some of the debate as we watch these live pictures from Fulton County and Bedminster. But thank you very much indeed to Brian Lanza and Richard Painter for your thoughts this evening. We're going to take a short break. We'll be right back.
Hello there. It's the final week of summer 2023, and it does look as though the season is determined to go out on a rather unsettled note. But that said, it's not always going to be raining. We have low pressure in charge at the minute. In the coming days, it will be producing some downpours, which could be heavy and thundery, but not always. There will be sunshine to enjoy as well. So through this evening, we have an area of low pressure still in charge towards the northwest. It's set to bring rain to western areas of Scotland and a few spots of rain for Northern Ireland as well. But elsewhere, for much of England and Wales, it's a largely dry picture. And for many of us tonight, with clearer skies, it is going to be cooler. Last night, temperatures stayed for most in and around the low teens, but some spots tonight will dip into the single digits. So a cooler start to tomorrow, but because of those clear skies, a largely dry start first thing, and there should be some good amounts of sunshine to enjoy during the first part of the day as well. Northerly winds will develop, keeping it feeling a little bit cooler and fresher towards the north and the west, with some outbreaks of rain here. Some scattered showers develop elsewhere through the day, and there is the potential that some of those will be heavy with some thunder and lightning. And towards the southeast, the temperatures start to fall back to normal for the time of year, 21 degrees in London. That's down by about 5 degrees on today. Into Saturday, well, the low pressure stays with us, those northerly winds keeping it cooler and fresher towards the north and the west with a few spots of rain. As the day gets going, we're going to see scattered showers popping up, and when they do, they could well be very heavy, some thunder and lightning likely to be in the mix as well, but there will be sunshine in between those showers, so it's not always going to be raining through the day on Saturday. Into Sunday, we have another weather system in the Atlantic, and that's going to move in slowly as it does so, bringing a lot of cloud, and there will be a good bit of rain coming in to Northern Ireland. As that system nudges eastwards, it will begin to fizzle out, but bringing a lot of cloud to many other areas of the UK. It's Bank Holiday Monday for many of us, and it does look as though it will be a fairly decent day for many, largely dry, some sunshine coming and going. So into Sunday, a little bit unsettled the further north and west. For Monday, there will be a lot of dry weather and some sunshine for quite a few of us.
Yeah. Artificial intelligence is getting smarter. What does this mean for all of us? Panorama takes a deep dive into this evolving tech. From reading minds to hiring and firing. Does danger await or a dazzling future? Panorama Beyond Human, Artificial Intelligence and Us. Watch on BBC iPlayer.
Never miss a story. Get the headlines as they happen. And watch BBC News live wherever you are. Download the BBC News app.
Experience racism. Why do you walk away?
That's a really good question.
You're a politician.
I'm not a politician. I don't read the polls.
Yeah,
I've been a judiciary committee.
No, you are very definitely a politician.
No.
The very fact that there were not people looked like you.
Hold on. I'm only halfway through my answer.
Is secret schooling happening across Afghanistan for girls?
It does.
You simply can't assume that.
Actually, yes, you can.
Hard Talk. Watch on BBC iPlayer.
Hello, I'm Christian Fraser, and this is The Context.
President Trump, I believe, was the best president of the 21st century. It's a fact.
We have to face the fact that Trump is the most disliked politician in America. We can't win a general election that way.
I'm incredibly proud of the record of the Trump-Pence administration. I mean, in 4 short years, we rebuilt our military. We revived our economy. We unleashed American energy.
It was 58 minutes into the Republican debate last night before one of the moderators mentioned the elephant that was not in the room. Donald J. Trump, the runaway leader who in just a few hours' time will drive